Good afternoon. So I have a clock in front of me which says 8 minutes. And I'm going to look at it very carefully. Within the panel, we are the youngest institution. And I also know several of you who are great leaders here. So it's a little embarrassing to talk about what I'm going to do is to draw from the, some couple of lessons which I've learned from the leaders which I've worked with. For example, Professor K.R.S. Murthy, I think he had done a great transformation at IIM Bangalore, and I think a lot of us have learned a lot from him. And I'll try and draw a little bit from my own, experience at IIM Udaipur. So essentially, when you look at this whole, because we were a young institution, we had an opportunity to look at saying, what can we do differently? And I think we had whole experience of IIMs which are already there for 50 plus years. So there's a lot one can learn from that. There's also interesting experience tried within a country. For example, Dr. Srikanth had tried a lot of interesting experience at SP Jain, and we could learn a lot from that. And there are also experiences from a globe in terms of, Harvard had completed 100 years, and there was a book out by Srikanth Datar and colleagues. So I think, and also there were a lot of experiences from Singapore and Hong Kong. They were all institutions which were built, outstanding institution built with a less than 20 years kind of thing. So I think, if I look at, as a leader, when I ask several leaders, I think there are only two things which we do. One is this whole idea of how do you create a vision of an institution? Because educational institution is built with at least a 20-year kind of journey. So the whole idea is how do we build a vision which you can enthuse the whole team around you? So that's one part. And the second, in terms of how do you finally execute it, where as a leader, all you do is create enabling environment. That can you create an enabling environment where people around you, in terms of student, faculty, staff, can thrive? And the most appropriate leadership style in such a context is essentially servant leadership, where you as a director are essentially trying to make sure that everybody does well. And primarily because, you're dealing with faculty who are better than you. You want to hire faculty who are better than you. So essentially this whole idea that how do you work as a leader where each individual is better than you. So I think this whole issue of can you create a vision and then kindly encourage everybody to excel in whatever they do. In general, whenever you look at any institution, you have a large number of stakeholders. So I think the whole challenge is, for us, we had so many stakeholders, but the whole idea is, how do we, satisfy multiple stakeholders? So I think the one challenge is, everybody drives in a different direction. So somewhere you have to figure it out. Some stakeholders you'll work with a horizon which is much longer. With some stakeholders you'll work with a horizon which is much shorter. So I think what we did was essentially ask certain key questions. In terms of the first is, what's your ambition? So as an institution, you're asking this question, what kind of ambition you have, and based on that, what kind of benchmark you want to set for yourself? Do you want to talk about a global context? Do you want to talk about within India? You want to be a best institution within NCR region? That's also fine. I think the key is understanding what kind of ambition you have, and based on that, what kind of benchmark you set. And when you do that, you need to understand what kind of resources you have. One can have an ambition, but finally, all of that requires certain resources. And finally, you need to look at the kind of environment you're in working. So for example, today, I think we have a great environment. For example, for IIMs, we have an act which allows us complete independence. Similarly, for our private institutions, right? AICT chairman talked about graded autonomy. So suddenly, I feel we are in a very different environment where all premier institutions have an autonomy which is unthinkable. And we also have this whole, you know, the way you look at what's happening in the globe, the center of economic gravity is shifting towards the east. So suddenly, I think as a, all of us have a great opportunity where can we build an institution which is, can be, you know, India has an opportunity to hub of a management education. So that's a very interesting environment. The last important piece is in terms of kind of horizon. I think if you want to work on an ambition in terms of building a great institution, then you need to work with a horizon which is much longer. So we were very lucky where a board allowed us to look at a horizon which was 20 years. Because if you want to build an institution which is an outstanding institution, you know, you need to work with a horizon which are much longer. What we did was that if you're a young institution in a very crowded space, you know, we were 13th IIM, and management education was fairly mature in the country, is to try and focus on few things and try and do the well. So as an institution, we decided we are going to focus on a high quality research as the main thrust area and put all our energy in it. So essentially, we have used essentially framework by, you know, Prahlad, which is a strategic intent, where essentially you identify a loose brick, we identify research as a loose brick, put all our energy in it, and then build layers of competitive advantage. So essentially, we are saying we've started the research, now we are focusing on a high quality education, right? Then we'll talk about impact on society. So I think given that as a young institution, you would have a bandwidth which is not going to be very wide, it's important to focus quite a lot. So I think, you know, I'm just going to close here by just focusing on the key part in terms of first, you have to work with a horizon which is very long. Unfortunately, a lot of us work with a horizon which are very short. So work with a horizon which is very long. Second, focus on building a right culture, you know. And you need to make sure you keep talking about it, you know, all the time. Because finally, if you're talking about a 20-year horizon, only thing which will sustain you is going to be your values and culture. And finally, you know, you need to work with a partnership because as a young institution, you're not going to have too many resources. Look at a partnership. But finally, you also need a luck on your side. So somewhere you've been lucky. So you need to pray also that do all these things, but finally pray things work out for you. Thank you.